I'm going to go out on a limb, partner. I got a sneaky suspicion Kawhi Leonard's going to get the ball.
Leonard. On Butler. By Redick. Rebound by Ibaka. He has been unbelievable off the bench. Lowry.
And you don't need to foul if you're Philly.
Timeout. Philadelphia.
And right now, if you're Philly, this is the most important 8 seconds of your season. You have got to force a miss or a turnover and make sure you secure that defensive backboard.
Gasol will inbound to Lowry. Siakam, Leonard. With two to fire. Out of bounds, it'll be Philadelphia's ball. Gasol held Harris, no call.
They did the job defensively there, did the Sixers, to give themselves a chance. Now the question is, do you go for three or do you try to get a quick two and play the possession game?
Philadelphia has just used their final timeout.
And if you're Philly, there's enough time here where you can go quick if you can get an easy two.
Simmons, it's Jimmy Butler. Joel Embiid, Siakam on him. Redick. Embiid, Lowry knocked it away. Embiid gathers it in. A lunge and a foul on Toronto.
Fortunate there. How about Kyle Lowry almost comes away with that steal? That's a questionable one there as well, but Embiid will go to the line.
Where he is, 6 of 7. 19 points, 11 rebounds in 45 minutes. He's averaged 29 minutes in the series.
And right now, if you're Brett Brown, as you see, Nick Nurse bringing in Van Vliet for ball handling, knowing that you're probably going to get fouled, you want to be strong with the ball and not turn it over if you're Toronto.
Siakam leaves. As G.A. just said, Van Vliet is in. Leonard, Redick the foul. 10.8. 6 of 6. Leonard from the line with 38. 38 points on 38 shots. That's a quick look at this game 7 three-point shooting by the top three-point shooters for Brett Brown.
Redick obviously is the first option. Tobias Harris as well, but I wouldn't be surprised if Jimmy Butler, who loves the moment, if he gets the opportunity to take it.
Short, caught by Harris. 2-point game. Here comes Butler, driving layup is caught! He ties the game! 4.2 to go! Knifing his way, Jimmy Butler!
This is as good as it gets. Now, if you're Philly, you got to play without fouling. And with 4 seconds, ton of time for Toronto to get a good look here. And it doesn't have to be catch and shoot. You got time to take 2-3 dribbles. You can make a couple passes even if you can catch the defense sleeping.
Ennis is in for Philadelphia. Gasol will inbound. Siakam back in.
You got to be aware of the inbounder here if you're Philly.
It's off to Leonard. Defended by Simmons. Is this the dagger?
No!
Game! Series! Toronto is won!
What a game. Ferguson with the switch on to Lillard. Lillard kicks it. McCollum. Little teardrop. He's good. Off the glass. CJ McCollum makes it a 4-point game.
They got to get the ball to Paul George right here. You got to find a way. He's been carrying it all night. He's been solid. Let's see if they can find Paul George in his possession.
McCollum has 8 in the quarter. Here goes Westbrook. Gives it up. Grant, no. And Harkless with the board on the ground. So as Harkless hit the deck, a foul on the Thunder. Westbrook hit for the foul, which is his fifth. And that'll send Harkless to the line. He just made his last two after he missed four in a row. George with five, Westbrook with five.
Yeah, I mean, that's a pretty tight foul there late in this game. Russell was going for the offensive glass and might have pushed him a little bit, but not much of a fun. The Harkless has got to knock these two free throws down.
He rattles it home. He's made three in a row now after he missed four straight. And it's a three-point game.
Well, I said it last possession, but this possession, they better find Paul George. He's been carrying him all night, Brian. And, man, you don't go away from your guy right now. He's been very good for you all game, and let him carry you home.
And remember, Portland's strategy in game four was to leave Westbrook open. Nurkic enjoying this one. Two-point game. Timeout on the floor. Thunder with one timeout remaining. Blazers have two left. Neither with a foul to give, each in the bonus. Two-point game. Thunder with a ball in the lead. George lost a handle, and it's into the hands of Curry. A takeaway by Portland. Costly turnover for the Thunder. Blazers can tie or take the lead as we hit the one-minute mark in regulation. George on McCollum. This is a long two for the tie. Points in the quarter for C.J. McCollum. A 21-6 run for the Blazers. Defense! Defense! Westbrook gives it to George. George will pull the mid-range, and he hits it. And the Thunder regain the lead. And Terry Stotts will use one of his two remaining timeouts. 12 assists. Here comes Damian Lillard on the take, spins it off the window, and we are tied again. What a finish by Lillard. He's got 47.
And they went 2-for-1, so they're guaranteed the last shot here this game.
Westbrook takes on Aminu. Westbrook, no. And it's Aminu with the rebound. Chance right here. Shot clock is off. Portland has a timeout. Lillard, a chance to send the Thunder home. Lillard, long range three, and it's good! At the buzzer, Damian Lillard! Are you kidding me? Derek White.
White drives on Durant, keeps his dribble alive. He stepped out of bounds.
And here's the problem. If you're Derek White and you come off that screen, you've done your job if Kevin Durant defends you, because the whole action is to get the ball to Tatum with Curry defending him.
I would not be reluctant to take a foul right now on Claxton again before the 2 minute mark.
Irving says, let's settle down. Brown's nose is really bleeding. Irving against White. Irving drives. Irving stops, falling away. Won't go. Horford the rebound. Al Horford, 18 points, 12 boards. All tied up with just over a minute and a half remaining.
And what Marcus Smart does, gets the matchup, gets the ball to Tatum. That's the right read.
Tatum, the Smart three-pointer. Back of the rim, won't go. Fight for the rebound. Curry has it as Brown mistimed his jump.
Durant in the front court. Drives on White. Durant gets in the paint, lost it momentarily. Now takes the shot. Bounces in. Kevin Durant with a bucket. And the Nets back up by two.
And you're right, Jaylen Brown is really bleeding right now.
And James Williams, the official, spots that, so they're going to have to attend to him once again.
Steve Nash had to come out of a playoff game once. They couldn't get it started.
Against San Antonio. Both these teams feel they can win a championship this year, but one of these teams will not even make it out of the first round. Smart drives, goes inside, adjusts, layup on goal. Horford the rebound, back up, and he banks it home to tie the game. Had to step over his teammate to do it.
Under a minute remaining. Irving looking. Seven to shoot. Irving step back three. Puts it in. Kyrie Irving with the long three-pointer. And the Celtics call timeout. Brooklyn back up by three. What a fourth quarter masterpiece from Kyrie Irving.
They want to get a two for one here.
Jaylen Brown drives on and lays it up and in. Brown with a beautiful aggressive move. Still 38.9 remaining, 1 point lead for Brooklyn.
And that's a poor possession defensively. They all spread out and allowed Brown just to get right to the rim.
Well, the Celtics, the best defensive team in the NBA this year, need a stop here. Irving gets away from the double team, continues into the paint, scrambling, double teamed again, back out to Durant, shot clock at two. Durant's got to put it up, gets it off in time, off the mark, no good. Horford the rebound. Celtics have a timeout, decide not to use it here. Brown the drive. Jaylen Brown kicks it out. Smart fakes. Inside. Tatum spins and he puts it in. Celtics go up by one. They wave it off. They're waving off whether or not to check to see if the game ended. The basket counts. As Tatum puts it in, the officials go to the scoreboard.
And what a play by Marcus Smart. Turns down the shot, gets into the paint, realizes he has enough time to get the ball into the hands of Tatum. And Tatum with the spin, the patience, and the basket. That's outstanding.
They count it. They count it. It's over.
Let's look at the possession. He could very well elevate here. Realizes he has the time, is patient, gets into the seams, delivers the on-point pass to Tatum, and he gets it off in the nick of time.
And when you close there, it's easy to say, but you got to close under control.
And Tatum finishes with 31 by mistake, saying waving it off. They were wanting to make sure that it came before. It was so close to the final buzzer. As Tatum gets it, and what a thrilling finish. Paul George to the basket, lays it up and in. Just his third field goal. He was just 2 for 12, but he puts the Clippers back up by one.
2 minutes remaining.
Doncic, Kleba, Burke. Burke against Morris, little razzle-dazzle with a dribble. Drives, reverse layup. Rebound tipped and taken by Jackson. And Paul George, the crossover, drives hard, layup. That misses. And Kleba, another rebound.
I thought last possession, Kleba turned down a wide open shot. He's too good of a shooter and a player. You get that open shot, you're not going to get a better look.
Doncic against Paul George, step back three. Air ball, Burke the rebound, puts up the baseline jumper, rattles in and out and in again.
Trey Burke!
What a performance from Trey Burke. Dallas back up by one. Lou Williams quickly counted and one. Lou Williams continues to put on a scoring show. He's got 35.
When you talk about the all-time greats in the history of this game that's come off the bench, you have to talk about Lou Williams. The way he scores the basketball time and time again when called upon. Just a spectacular, spectacular ball game.
And you've got to get active defensively. So you got beat away from the screen. You're guarding Reggie Jackson in the corner. You got to give help. Lou Williams is not missing an uncontested layup.
And doesn't miss the free throw. 36 points. For the most prolific bench scorer in the history of the NBA. Clippers by two. Doncic. Finney-Smith throws it back up top. Kleba now back to Doncic. Gets in the paint, drives it more, steps back and banks it home to tie it again. And the Clippers call timeout.
Timeout LA.
A Doncic masterpiece here in game four. Luka Doncic, 38 points, 16 rebounds, 13 assists. Doc Rivers' team, after blowing a 21-point lead, came back and erased a 12-point fourth-quarter deficit.
And they're going to want to get two shots for one.
Leonard, the drive, the pull-up shot is short. Rebound, Doncic.
And I would try to do the same thing if I was the Mavericks right now.
Finney Smith hesitated.
And you can't have guys hesitating right now.
I like this matchup about Luka. Could use that strength.
Spins on Jackson. Layup. It's good. 40-point triple-double. And the Mavericks are up two. Timeout, Clippers, with 19 seconds remaining. An electrifying performance from Luka Doncic. George will inbound. Leonard, Morris. Into the hands of Kawhi Leonard. Kid Gilchrist is on him. Makes his move, gets into the paint, stops, kicks it out. Morris, a corner three, puts it in! Marcus Morris from downtown! And the Clippers take a one-point lead. Timeout, Dallas. Well, the Clippers now by one. Dallas still has a timeout left as Doncic obviously will get the ball into his hands out there with Hardaway, Curry, Finney Smith, and Kleba.
But obviously they're going to play through Luka, but if you're the other guys, just like Morris, you have to be ready, locked and loaded to shoot the basketball.
Now the Clippers do have a foul to give here.
And I'm surprised Trey Burke is not on the floor for Kleba.
Kleba to inbound. Doncic goes in the backcourt. Again, they've got that foul to give. Doncic, and there it is. Jackson fouls him with 3.7 seconds remaining. And the Mavericks will have to inbound again.
A smart play by Reggie Jackson and the Clippers, understanding that they had the foul to give and took it at the right time.
And by throwing it in the backcourt, that took more time off the clock. Damn it, guarding the ball, I'm going to track Doncic and try to prevent that ball from coming into him.
Finney Smith to inbound. Back to Doncic. Doncic pulls up, three-pointer. Bang! Bang! It's good! Doncic wins the game at the buzzer!
Let's go! Luka Doncic! Boom! Shaka Luka!
Lillard hit a couple of big shots at the end of the third overtime. What does he have for us here in overtime number four with his team down two, nearing a minute to go? Hood backing down Murray. He's got the freshest legs of anybody on the floor. Takes the shot and makes it to tie it at 133, just outside a minute to go. And we've got a timeout by Denver.
Disciplined on taking away back cuts. They've got to continue to do that.
Here's Barton driving on McCollum, got tied up, gets it back, hangs, and a foul is called. And Barton will go to the line, looking to give Denver the lead. C.J. McCollum picks up the personal. That is his fourth foul.
Well, we get the benefit of this, right? The slow ball.
Does he have all ball there?
It looks like he's got a lot of ball.
Will Barton with 21 points since halftime, but he missed the first free throw.
That guy looks like he's under pressure and in agony. Settle down, my man. This is up to the players.
One out of two for Barton. And a one-point Denver lead inside a minute to go. What a game. What a series between these two outstanding teams. Here's Hood. Working against Murray, trying to take him instead of pull up, and hit again! Rodney Hood, the story late here in overtime number four, Blazers by one. Murray to Jokic on the drive, kicks it out. Shot clock at eight, Millsap goes to the left hand, and it rolls in! What a shot by Millsap to give Denver a one-point lead. Timeout Portland, 27.6 remaining in the fourth overtime. You would imagine make or miss. There's going to be a timeout by Denver, and Murray will get back in for offense. Inbound to Cantor. McCollum's going to go and get it back. McCollum driving over two Nuggets. Off the heel. Got it back to Hood. He'll try a three. And got it! Blazers by two. Timeout Denver. Denver's out of timeouts. Portland has one remaining. Blazers are not going to guard the inbound here. Murray back on the court. Millsap gets it into Jokic. And here's Murray. Denver down two. Murray calls off Jokic. He's got Aminu on him. Jokic wants the ball. 7 seconds left. Jokic backing down. Harkless spins. And a foul is going to be called with 5.6 seconds left. It's going to put a guy that's played 65 minutes tonight at the free throw line to try and tie the game for Denver. Fourth foul on Harkless. Jokic, 82% free throw shooter during the regular season, 88% in the playoffs. 2 for 3 tonight. And he missed the first one.
Now you've got a foul. And Beasley gets the instruction. He's telling the teammates now.
And they got a foul to give, so they're going to have to foul twice. Jokic got the second one. Portland by one. Terry Stotts will use the Blazers' final timeout. One, and Jokic with one. Hood will inbound. Jokic guarding the inbound. Do they get it to Lillard in the backcourt? Beasley trying to catch up to him. Does. That takes 2 full seconds off the clock before Denver can commit that foul. They will not guard the inbounder closely here with 3.5 to go. And again, if Denver doesn't get a steal, there will be a foul immediately.
Now the danger, though, is if you steal it, your shot's easier.
Well, they just took Jokic out of the game, and there's no timeout, so you can't bring him back into the game. Hood trying to get it in. They do to Seth Curry. He's fouled with 2.8 on the clock.
Great job. Great job by Seth to recognize.
Remember, Denver doesn't have a timeout. They can't advance the ball. Now Jokic can check back in here because of the free throws. Jamal Murray picked up the foul. 2.8 on the clock. Seth Curry, 75% free throw shooter during the regular season. But limited attempts here in the playoffs, 4 of 6, and none tonight. Younger brother of Steph on a 6th NBA team. Missed all of last year with an injury. Calmly cans Portland's first free throw of all the overtimes. And with the next one, can make it a 3-point lead.
Keep everybody in front. No fouls.
And again, no timeouts left for Denver. 3-point lead for Portland. 2.8 seconds left here in game 3 with a series tied 1 apiece. Baseball pass Millsap. Picked off by McCollum, and it's finally over. The Blazers win it in 4 overtimes. They take a 2-1 lead.
But 3's there and he's feeling it. Let it fly. If not, get to the mid-range or to the rim.
All right, the Nets looking to inbound. Jeff Green gets it into Durant. Here is Durant moving on Tucker. He turns, he shoots. Yes! With 1 second remaining. 1 second left. Durant hits a three. And Milwaukee has one timeout. They call for the timeout. What an incredible shot by Kevin Durant to try to make things difficult for Holiday, who will throw it in. Durant is on Adetokounmpo. There's Holiday looking, can't find anybody, gets it in. Giannis with the shot way off, and we go to overtime. Back to Durant. Harris for three. He's off. Rebound Brown, and he puts it in. Bruce Brown able to get to the rebound and lay it up. 14 on the shot clock for the Nets. Now Durant going on against Middleton, met by the double. There's Harris. Harden for three. Rebounded by Lopez. Giannis on the drive. Hands to Lopez. And he's tied up. Durant went right for the ball and tied him up. Early on by Durant. Mark Davis just checking the feet to make everybody sure that everyone is in the right place. And then Lopez bats at it. And last touch by the Nets.
Once again, Durant, like Harden earlier, tried to steal that tip. Right now, this isolation play effective on this out-of-bounds play. Giannis gets it and goes, causing all types of problems.
Play by Griffin goes right at him, and a blocking foul on Griffin.
And he can get that anytime he wants. When he makes up his mind and drives in isolation, puts so much pressure on the defense.
10 seconds remaining on the shot clock for the Bucks. Antetokounmpo turns, flips it, and it carries in. So the game is tied. A minute 5 remaining. There's Durant, blocked by Lopez, comes to Harris, who fires, and he's off. Rebounded Lopez.
And what a weak side block right there, Brook Lopez.
45 seconds left in overtime. 10 on the shot clock. Middleton spinning and hits. Big bucket for Chris Middleton. And the Bucks take the lead. 113-111. And the Nets call for tie. We've had 10 ties, 20 lead changes.
Hits the ball and goes into his movement for Bucks possibly running at him, trying to double team him.
Jeff Green gets it in. Durant, played by Middleton. Here's Durant on the drive. The jumper is no good. It's short. Rebound, Antetokounmpo.
Great rebound. Smart decision to get it out of his hands and the hands of Middleton.
Seconds to go in overtime. 7 on the shot clock. Here's Middleton. Off the mark. Rebound Durant. Down to 10 seconds left. Harden back to Durant. Guarded by Holiday. Durant for 3. Comes up with an air ball with 3/10 of a second remaining. All right, here's Giannis blooping one to Lopez, and that'll do it. The Bucks beat the Nets in 7. They do it in overtime. They're headed to the Eastern Conference Final, where they'll take on the winner between the Sixers and the Hawks.
Kawhi Leonard surveying the court. Leonard pulls up, shot won't go, rebound, Cousins. 1 minute remaining. Curry trying to get free. Leonard pokes it away, but Green goes back to get it. Still plenty of time on the shot clock. Cousins on the drive across the lane, layup is good. 1-point game.
And here's the question again, timeout or no timeout?
And I say no timeout. I'm not going to allow you to get better defenders on the floor. They choose to call the timeout.
Oh, Nick Nurse wants to talk it over. DeMarcus Cousins playing big minutes with all the injuries with a huge bucket to cut it to 1. Toronto with a 1-point lead. They'll inbound in their front court.
They've substituted Looney for Cousins for better defense. But if they get the stop and want to play in transition, they have less offensive players on the floor.
But that's why I don't call a timeout, allowing them to put Looney on the floor instead of Cousins.
No fouls to give. Siakam drives, gets past Green, throws it up and in. Pascal Siakam makes it a 3-point game.
Steve Kerr's got the same decision.
Curry gets inside, falls down, and a trip call.
But now it's just going to be a free throw shooting game.
So Curry will shoot 2. The shot clock will be turned off. And one of the great free throw shooters who's ever played will shoot 2. You see there, 4 for 4 tonight. Here's the play. Curry gets past Siakam. Ooh, it looked like he hit his own foot to knock himself down. Two clutch free throws there. Back to one.
You got to be aggressive, looking to steal the basketball while thinking commit the foul.
I'm going to take one trap at least.
Lowry looking and has to call a timeout. Good ball denial from Golden State. As they advance the ball to the front court, Danny Green comes in. Van Vliet, Leonard, Siakam, and Lowry will inbound.
I don't want the ball hitting Leonard's hands. Anybody else, I'm fine with.
Lowry throws it in the backcourt to Leonard. Here comes the double team. Leonard still in the backcourt, throws it ahead to Green. Green surrounded by Draymond Green and throws it away! Throws it away! Warriors ball with 9.6 remaining! And Steve Kerr calls timeout! No fouls to give. Golden State also out of timeouts. Curry, Green, Iguodala, Cousins. Iguodala's going to take it out of bounds. Cook also on the floor. 9.6 remaining.
I'm not going to screen for Curry. I'm going to get him the ball and get out of his way.
An NBA championship on the line. Iguodala throws it to Green, who catches it. Back to Curry. Puts up a three. Won't go. Rebound Cousins. Deflected. Picked up by Leonard. Ball still loose. They dive on it and try and call time. And a timeout call.
So it's a technical foul.
They had no timeouts remaining. So a technical foul will be called on Golden State. It's still not over yet. The officials will meet as Mark Davis, John Goble, and David Guthrie discussing the situation.
But trying to make the right play, great hustle. This is the right play if you had a timeout. And this should have been discussed, I'm sure, in the huddle during the timeout that we're out of them.
But if he doesn't call a timeout, the clock runs out, the game is over. And then again, Toronto will get possession. Even though Green had possession when he called timeout, you lose possession with the excessive timeout. Now they just have to inbound the ball and the celebration will be underway.
And it should be a celebration both ways. This is the last time at Oracle Arena. And if I'm this crowd, I'm standing and appreciating what this team has done.
Lowry has it. Throws it into Leonard. That's it. It's over. The Raptors win. Yeah, there's a new NBA. Oh, they call a foul. Well, Leonard could steal it at the line as he hits the first.
You know it's over, right?
Yes.
You're still coaching.
Crowd still here hoping for a miracle. Also here to cheer on. Leonard makes it official. Now the Warriors just inbound and that's it. There's a new NBA champion, and it's a team from Toronto, Canada. We the North are now we the champions. The Raptors, the 2019 NBA champs.
Tatum with 37.
Now you got a bigger body and Harris guarding Tatum.
Cross court, Horford, three. Rebound, Brown, tips it out, Brogdon, three. Rebound, Horford. Kicks it out to Smart. Offensive rebounding. Smart. Horford. Oh!
And again, the two guys that do all the dirty work.
This is Harden's 10th career playoff game with 40 points. Smart will defend. Now they'll switch with Tatum. Smart, by the way, 10 points in this fourth quarter. Has been terrific for the Celtics. They go to Reed, good feed, down low, he goes, fouled as he was trying to machete his way for two.
So much attention to James Harden. And Paul Reed really got a runway start right here on this high screen and roll.
Smart picked up his third foul. He was met in mid-flight by both Tatum and Smart, and Reed to the line for the first time tonight. 6 points, 13 rebounds, replacing in the lineup Joel Embiid. Reed.
Man, that is big time pressure right there by Paul Reed, a guy who's not really used to being in this type of environment and situation in the playoffs.
Reed was 1-1 in the Brooklyn series from the line.
Oh,
he's 2 of 2 tonight and makes it another 1-point game.
Nothing but net by Reed.
Full court pressure here by Philly. Locked in with 20 points. Harden is there defending. Shot clock is down to 10. Smart. It's Brown transitioning. Harris defending. Smart thought three, got by the defense. Here comes Tatum, one to fire. Brogdon, it's intercepted. Maxey's got it. The shot clock didn't go off. Maxey the other way, slams it down. Philadelphia's got the lead. Maxey stole the ball. Timeout taken, Boston.
Melton has come in for Maxey. Here's the try by Tatum. Hard foul, down he goes, 26 seconds to go. Each team with a timeout. At the line will be Tatum, 5 of 6 tonight. Watch it again.
Good call, easy call.
Harris picks up his first. And Tatum to the stripe. He set a record this season for Boston scoring. 30 points was an all-time Celtics record, and that's saying something. Just got by Larry Bird.
You're wondering if Doc, with that one timeout, if they have already come up with a play, if they're going to go with it and call it to advance it.
Melton is out. Niang has come in for the Sixers. And Boston by one.
They're going.
And the full court is there. And Harden with 42 tonight. Tucker getting ready to set a screen. Harden works around it, drives the defense of Horford. Difference of 2 seconds, game clock and shot clock. Harden sizing up Horford. It's a three. Good! Harden's got 45! Timeout, Boston! 2 point Sixer lead.
Well, they got the switch they wanted. Al Horford guarding James Harden. Ties his career playoff high with 45.
10-4 run Philadelphia. Harden has put in 15 fourth quarter points. Sixers lead by 2. 8.4 to go. Boston's out of timeouts. Here comes Smart into Harden. The feed, the loose ball. Reed had a hand on it with a whistle and a foul, and that goes on Tatum. It goes on Tatum.
And it sends Reed back to the free throw line where he just buried 2. Timeouts for Boston to advance it. So they've got to go even if Reed misses one. He hasn't even touched any part of the rim.
Philadelphia 11 of 11 from the line tonight. And Boston is 17 of 18. And Philadelphia does have a timeout. 3-point lead and one free throw coming up.
But plenty of time for Boston to go coast to coast if this is a missed free throw.
Philly is on a 12-4 run. Here comes Smart. 4-point game. He'll take a three. The rebound lead. Philadelphia has won. The Sixers have captured game one without Embiid. Harden spectacular. 45 points. And this is Philadelphia's first game one win in Boston since 1981.
But they're still in mourning here. The Bruins lost last night. The Celtics in game one stunned.
Toronto has missed their last 5 shots. They are down 4 as we approach the 2-minute mark. Van Vliet passed up a 3. Nothing there. Can't get by. Now Lowry does get by. Goes to the hole and scores a tough layup.
Kyle Lowry's had great success all night attacking the basket. He does again. Once he gets to the paint, he's very strong. Can finish through contact.
Brown, he'll take it. Comes up short. Tice keeps it alive. Tatum, bullet pass. Brown scores it. What a play by Tatum.
Great pass by Tatum, but a great effort play by Tice to keep the ball alive and give them an opportunity at a second chance.
Back to a four-point lead. Brown all over Siakam. A defensive stand there by Jaylen Brown.
That's what we were saying earlier. Just waiting to get Jaylen Brown back on Siakam. Siakam has not been able to do anything with Jaylen Brown this entire series.
Kemba Walker misses badly. That would have been a huge hit for the Celtics. Toronto only down four with the ball. Coming up on a minute left. Here's Lowry on the take. Lowry again with a layup.
Kyle Lowry's been fantastic tonight going to the basket. Once he gets a step into the lane, he's seeking out contact. He knows that getting into the body keeps the shot blocker off balance. He has no chance to get up. Always been a very, very good finisher in there.
Toronto has a foul to give. Tatum, pull up. No. Chance here for Toronto. They're down two. Clock ticks. And that's out of bounds. Last touch by Walker. 17 on the shot clock. And the Raptors want to talk this one over. Don't
to free somebody up for a corner three.
Toronto is in the penalty. No fouls to give for Boston. Now a three-pointer is up and no. Offensive rebound, Anunoby. Back to Van Vliet. They'll get it set up again. Two-point game, Van Vliet. Oh, what a finish with the left hand by Van Vliet. And we are tied at 101.
Nick Nurse wants a foul there, and I'm going to agree with him on that. I thought he had an and one, but a great finish by Van Vliet. And now Boston's going to hold for the last shot.
And a chance to go up 3-0. Toronto does have a foul to give. Walker and the double team gets by. Walker dishes. Tice with the dunk with 0.5 left.
Well, they went out to blitz to trap Kemba Walker, but he was able to get around and keep his dribble alive and then sort of looked him off and made the bounce pass to Tice. Lowry stepped up to help. Siakam got looked off. He was running out to the three. You watch Siakam here. That's his sink. He should be down on Tice. He was worried about the pass coming out to the three. And then they are able to make the pass for the dunk. So he gets around here, the trap a little bit, gets around Gasol into the paint. Good help by Lowry. Siakam has to sink.
Wow.
Right there.
How about that? A no-look pass to give Boston the lead. Van Vliet with an acrobatic left-handed layup with some spin to tie the game. And now Boston leads by 2.5 remaining. And one last desperation opportunity here for Toronto. Special play by Kemba Walker.
And Taco Fall is going to make an appearance here.
Good call.
Taco Fall is either going to be on the ball, which I assume he will be, to make the pass very, very difficult.
At 7 feet, 5 inches.
Yes, and he will be. He is going to guard the ball.
Toronto able to advance it here.
And Kyle Lowry is going to have to inbound against Taco Fall.
Oh, wow, Kyle Lowry at not even 6 feet.
Boston is going to zone up here on the side out of bounds. They're going to be switching everything back here. Marcus Smart's going to stay up high, taking anybody coming to the ball.
Series on the line. Anunoby got it off, and it goes! Did it count is the question. OG Anunoby buries a triple at the buzzer.
Just an absolutely great pass by Kyle Lowry. Let's see
Ruling
if he got
floor,
it
successful
up.
Successful field goal.
Kyle Lowry over the top. Gasol just screened in enough. That ball's gone,
it's
I
clean.
Think.
It's
That's
a game winner.
In and a great winner. Great shot by OG Anunoby, but an incredible pass by Kyle Lowry over Taco Fall for the game winner. Boston
successful
zoned up at the end. Great play and a huge win for the Toronto Raptors.
Forcing the action. Down to 2:20 remaining in the fourth.
Gilgeous Alexander gets it to Harrell, and he puts it down.
Dunk on the whole team off the vertical then. Harrell going to work in the paint.
It's a three-point game. 23 points for Harrell. 9 for 9 from the field. Durant for three. Way off. Rebound Harrell. Just under 2 left in the fourth. Clippers trying to get back into this series to tie it at 1. Williams off the fake and gives it to Harrell. He tried to return, could not. And then it's picked off at center court by Shabbat. Williams played by Green. Williams goes at Draymond Green, who blocks it, but a foul. It is on Green. That is his fourth.
Harrell is a beast in the paint, smart defensively, and he's athletic, so he definitely will catch you and take that poster home. And here, Lou Williams, one of the best at drawing a foul. Draymond keeping great position there. Lou forcing the issue, getting back to the line.
He's an 87% free throw shooter during the regular season. Lou Williams coming out in the second half now has 32 points, 8 of 9 from the line. Misses on the second, so Golden State up by 2. Just under a minute and a half remaining in the fourth quarter. A game that appeared to be on the way to a decisive blowout. And a foul is called on the Warriors. It is on Durant, number 6 on Kevin Durant.
And his 8th turnover. Setting the screen, and that's where, no, it's not Patrick Beverley, but yeah, that's where everything works out. Look, he does stick his butt out there. Really good call. He's trying to get Curry a wide open look.
You can't do this now. You cannot.
What'd he do?
He's arguing with the official.
Oh, no, no. Yeah, the play's over, and it was a foul.
You cannot take a chance of a technical, which would hurt the Warriors on the scoreboard, and it would be number 3 of this, the first 2 games.
And Marv, this is what we're talking about. Yeah, the Warriors are okay, all that good stuff, but this is why Steve Kerr looks the way he does on the side of the bench. It's not just about one play. It's about the habits that you set, and right now with the turnovers, he's not happy with the Warriors' play.
This is Lou Williams. Lou Williams knocks it down, and the game is tied at 1:28 as we come up on a minute remaining of the fourth. Looney has come on for Durant. Here's Curry for 3. Yes! Doc Rivers calls for time. 131-128, Golden State. 55 seconds left. And on that 3 by Curry, it's a 3-point lead for the Warriors, who have led by as many as 31. Here's Williams, puts on the brakes, and scores. He has 36, and it's a 1-point game.
When Curry gives up the ball, you must stay with him. Maybe even try to deny. Too late.
Thompson for 3. Rebounded by the Clippers. We're down to 25 seconds remaining, fourth quarter. Williams, played by Curry. An open shot. Shabbat able to knock it down. First lead for the Clippers since it was 12-11.
If you are the Warriors, you know you want to get the ball to Steph, but be careful because he can be a decoy with the live dribble, pass it, and get it back off of the screens.
Curry for Iguodala. Back to Curry. Steps back and shoots the 3. It is off. Rebound is battled around. 5 seconds remaining in this fourth quarter as the foul is called on Golden State. Harrell is 5 for 7 at the line, a 64% free throw shooter during the regular season. Golden State has 1 timeout remaining. Both teams are over the foul limit. It is now a 3-point Clipper lead.
representing their biggest lead of the night.
And of course, you don't want to foul here, but you better make sure if you're a Clipper that you go in to get the rebound and secure it. Make sure you have Harold's back on this play. No fouls.
So Harold is able to hit on both, and now the Warriors take their final timeout. 15 points in this fourth quarter for Harold. So 27 is the largest comeback win. 31-point lead by Golden State dissipated. Here's Thompson, has to fire up a three, would not matter, and that will do it. A remarkable comeback by the LA Clippers on the Warriors court here at Oracle, down by as many as 31. The Clippers defeat the Warriors in a classic, 135 to 131.
Offensively, he's using the offensive end of the floor to rest, and they need him.
Anthony Davis with 30 points and 21 rebounds. Finds James inside. Turnaround, no good. Davis offensive board, no! And it's in the hands of Curry. It's an 8-0 Warriors run. Green kicks it. Curry to Poole. Three-pointer! Down it goes!
Well, the transition game for the Warriors. Draymond Green there, excellent job pushing the pace. And the Warriors now want to go back in their zone.
Heavy legs. 11-0 run here for Golden State. Big possession. James kicks it. Russell for three. Air ball. Curry at the controls. Davis knocked it out of his hands.
But here it is, Green with the push, gets it deep, and then Curry penetrates. Multiple driving kicks. The Warriors just a lot quicker right now than the Lakers are. The Lakers look like they're playing in mud at this point.
Jordan Poole's got 21, just knocked down to 6-3. Reeves with Curry, 6 to shoot. There's a screen. Curry lets them all go by. Green on a rim run. Draymond Green missed the layup. Big stand by the Lakers. LeBron, head of steam, LeBron. And got a whistle prior to the travel. A Laker turnover as LeBron travels. Warrior ball.
He gets two after the gather. 1, 2, 3. Good call by Ed Malloy.
Thompson had to block. Still an 11-0 run. Curry got him dancing.
Well, they wanted to switch. They wanted to get Russell on him, and they got it.
Reset. Curry. Down it goes again. We are tied at 112. The magic of Stephen Curry.
And they want to go zone. Little confusion there.
14-0 run. Russell guarded by Wiggins. Tough shot. Big bucket for D'Angelo Russell. Lakers lead by two.
Well, they took Vanderbilt out because they were struggling to score. Wanted to get more offense on the floor. But just like the first quarter, Curry's gone on a flurry with Vanderbilt out of the game. This is the matchup he wants.
Curry blocked by Davis. LeBron pushes. James drives. He's fouled. Free throws for LeBron James. Wow. What action here between these two teams. Darvin Ham wants Vanderbilt back on the floor as James misses the first free throw. So Vanderbilt will return.
Yeah, they're going to try to play some offense defense as much as they can. They'll get Russell back in on offensive possessions.
LeBron with 22. One out of two at the line. Three-point game.
Again, we see Curry handling the ball. This has been the adjustment Steve Kerr has made that has worked so well.
Keep an eye on Curry without the ball. Guarded by Schroeder. And Schroeder, what a play. Into the hands of Wiggins. Big break for Golden State. Five to shoot. Jordan Poole But the Warriors down three. Take it on LeBron. Poole with a left hand. No! Anthony Davis was there defending. And now time on the Lakers side. They lead by three.
What a big possession here. I don't like it when teams run down the shot clock. The Warriors are going to have plenty of time. You need to go get a shot. James not leaving himself a lot of time.
For three. No! Curry with a rebound. Shot clock is off. Warriors down three. Curry double team. Jordan Poole lets it fly. No! Long rebound to Schroeder. Clock ticks. And finally a whistle comes. And it's going to be a timeout, Lakers. Quick foul here. Schroeder running the backcourt, and the clock ticks. Schroeder playing keep away, and with 2.7 left, Schroeder will go to the line to try to put this one away.
Good.
Dennis Schroeder off the bench. Ball game. 8 of 9 from the line. He's taken three more free throw attempts than the entire Warriors team. And he knocks down both, and the Los Angeles Lakers. Warriors went to 7 games with Sacramento. And after a furious run of 14-0, the Lakers scored the last 5 points. Green puts up the final shot, and that's it. Game one belongs to the Los Angeles Lakers.
1:59 to play.
Two minutes to play. Oladipo with the floater. I wasn't even close, and Tatum clears the glass. It almost feels like nothing but a stop will do here for Miami to stay alive.
And I like this. No pick and roll, so you're allowed to play one-on-one and see where the help is coming from.
Miami loading up at boxes and elbows. Tatum with the feed to Williams, who got stripped. What a steal by Lowry.
They need a three right here.
Oladipo in traffic, got it. And it's a 7-point game with 1:23 to go. Tatum in the front court. They're going to double him. Brown on the drive. Smart takes another three and missed. Heat still alive. Lowry makes it a 5-point game on an 8-0 run. Brown missed it. A late whistle. And James Capers calls a foul. Offensive foul with an elbow on Jaylen Brown.
And catches the defender in the jaw. Offensive foul.
Strus to make it a 2-point game. Connect. Splash! Miami within two. An 11-0 run by the Heat. Tatum with 8 on the shot clock. Smart. Fakes. Fires. Butler. He can tie. For the lead. Loose and Horford. Gonna have to foul. They do. Butler had a clean look, Jeff. And he went for the kill shot. And the lead.
I gotta say, I think that's a bad decision by Butler. That's not the strength of your game. You've made this remarkable comeback. You have Al Horford in front of you. They're gonna not help off of Strus. You have so much space there, you can attack.
Marcus Smart at the free throw line. 79% foul shooter, makes the first.
I'm in agreement with you, but if he makes that shot, he's a hero.
Well, that's what you have to live with as a best player.
At 35 in the game. Smart, if he makes this one, it becomes a two-possession ball game. And that's what it is, up by four with 11.4 to play. Game seven with a trip to San Francisco and the NBA Finals on the line.
Staying connected to Strus.
Strus connecting on that big three a moment ago. Here he is against Smart. Got a look. Front rimmed it. Loose ball whistle. And a loose ball foul going to go against the Celtics.
On the rebound by Oladipo. Good call. But without a timeout.
You don't mind because they got to take the ball back right out of bounds. Yep. So that's good execution.
Miami's still down four. Here's one more look at it.
Clearly a foul.
Last time they looked at Strus on the inbound pass. Lowry inbound again here. Strus again. Fires the three. And that might do it. Al Horford with the rebound. Throws it up in the air. And the Boston Celtics will go to the NBA Finals. They complete a wire-to-wire victory on Miami's home court. Holiday against Bridges. Pulls back. Middleton wants it. Good ball denial. Now Middleton comes out to get it. On the drive. Step back. Three-pointer. It's good! More Middleton magic. And the lead back up to eight. Whoa! Crowder up top to Booker. Booker drives on Giannis, gets inside. Scoop layup is good. Booker's got 37. 6-point game with two to play. Chris Middleton again on the drive, gets in the paint, stripped by Booker. Ball knocked loose out of bounds. And they say it's going to be Milwaukee ball. All against Connaughton. Booker comes for the ball, fires a three. Bang! Devin Booker from downtown. It's a 3-point game.
They got to get in their stuff a little bit earlier. Milwaukee.
Middleton to Holiday. Holiday the drive inside of Antetokounmpo. And he's fouled hard. Two free throws for Giannis with 109 remaining. Four fouls on Chris Paul.
Now this is the right play. You don't want Giannis to go up and score attacking the rim. Make a bad free throw shooter. Go to the line and make two. That's playoff basketball.
You know, of course, Antetokounmpo had back-to-back 40-point games in games two and three. Booker, back-to-back 40-point games. 42 in game four, 40 more tonight. Critical free throws here. It's been the one glaring weakness throughout his career. Right now, the two most important free throws of his NBA career. He's now 4-for-9 tonight.
And Monty Williams looks like he wants to call a timeout prior to the second shot.
Williams will call time. He'll be down to one timeout remaining. Missed a pair. Crowder the rebound. Paul makes his move, gets inside, the running layup is good. It's a 1-point game. Middleton trying to get free. Middleton bumps into Paul. They're letting him bang around. Middleton tied up, he's double teamed and calls timeout with five left on the shot clock. Smart play. He was in no position really to do anything. Ball in the far corner. Five to shoot for Milwaukee. Now to execute the play you work on time and time again in practice. Holiday gets it. Shot clock at three.
Holiday looks up, drives, throws it up. No good. Rebound, Booker. Suns have a timeout. Decide not to call it. Booker the drive, gets inside, leans in. Knocked away and stolen by Holiday. Phoenix has to foul, and a pinnacle ball throws it down. And a foul. Giannis on the alley-oop. What a turnaround. A chance to take the lead and the turnover as the Bucks now up by three and a free throw coming up.
What a play by Jrue Holiday. Gets into the pitcher, comes up with the strip. Turning the basketball over and then off to the races. Could have held it out, instead made the right read. Throws it up where only Giannis can catch it. Finishes it with the contact.
And bad decision to foul, because this would make it a four-point game with 13.5 remaining. Phoenix still has a timeout. Once again, a critical free throw for Giannis Antetokounmpo.
Missed it. Fight for the rebound. Tipped and taken by Middleton. And they have to foul Middleton with 9.8 remaining. They couldn't secure the defensive rebound.
Giannis now. Middleton.
He misses.
9.8 remaining. Middleton has been magnificent again with 28 points. Doesn't get to the line often here in these finals.
Clutch one right there.
And now Monty Williams will call his final timeout as the Bucks have a four-point lead.
They got to make them use time here. It's not as important, two or three, but without timeouts, make them use time.
Booker has it. Booker leans in. That's a two-pointer. Shot won't go. Rebound tip taken by Tucker. Knocked loose. Back out to Booker. Final seconds. Deflected. Pull. A three-pointer. It's over.
The Milwaukee Bucks are one win away from their first title in 50 years as they win on the road to take game five and now lead 3-2.
In a three-point game, Lillard telling him to get out of his way. Lillard on a three. And he hits.
Oh my goodness.
Damian Lillard, the late game assassin, strikes again.
Wow.
And we are headed to overtime here in game five. Does Lillard have some more late game magic up his sleeve? Gets it back, launches deep three, splash!
Wow. My goodness.
And because it's a two possession game, there's no reason to foul. Don't break your defensive principles. And if you can force a miss, you've got to secure that defensive backboard. And if you're Denver, get the ball to your stud and let him take advantage of the mismatch.
Jokic, five to shoot. Jokic against Anthony, contacts and a foul.
And that's big, because that's going to give you a reset now on that shot clock back to 14.
That was their last foul that they had to give. As Carmelo Anthony picks up his fourth.
And that was a great decision by Dame to give it up, reset, and then in essence almost like a repost to catch that.
Morris missed it. My goodness. On a night where he has done everything right, he leaves the door open. Lillard, he is a killer.
Oh, wow.
It just does not get any better than watching this man operate.
You are watching one of the greatest shot makers in the pressure moments in NBA history.
Jokic, Monte Morris, and Austin Rivers in terms of free throw shooters.
Inbound to Porter, now to Jokic. Here's Morris. And Powell come over and takes the foul. Had to do it there as those precious seconds come off the clock. So Monte Morris, who is a perfect 7 of 7 at the line tonight, 80% on the season, just can't overstate how huge he has been tonight for Denver.
21 of his 26 since halftime.
He has just been incredible and been a terrific compliment as they're going to take Jokic out, make a defense for offense substitution, understanding that this is going to be about defending that three-point line. And
missed it. That leaves the door open. Here he comes again. Lillard steps back, fires, banks it in again.
Oh my goodness. I cannot believe what I'm witnessing here, partner.
Damian Lillard ties it. 3 seconds. Rivers.
And that's a great play by Gordon. Attack that offensive glass. Get your team another opportunity.
Here's Jokic to skip. Porter for three. Got it. Denver takes the lead. Denver does have one foul to give. Damian Lillard, 55 points. He has set a new playoff record with 12 threes, if you just joined us. Anthony, now to Powell for the tie. No. Rebound Porter.
And honestly, I thought Carmelo had an opportunity to attack the basket there and get that deuce. You gotta be careful. You're in the penalty, and Jokic knows that.
Jokic likes the matchup, spinning fade, and the rebound by McCollum. Under a minute left in double overtime. Lillard, bounce inside, Covington missed the dunk.
Still enough time, though. That's a great setup there by Lillard, and Covington could not get the finish.
Jokic this time against the better defending Covington, puts it up, no, Covington clears, he played it perfectly.
They gotta get the ball over half court there.
Blazers have a timeout, they don't take it, for McCollum is out of bounds, my goodness. Throws it into the backcourt, it's Morris, and he is tracked down and fouled by Covington.
Very.
What a moment for their franchise tonight. McCollum on a three, missed it. Harrison is fouled. And Denver can finally put the Blazers away at the free throw line.
Ability of what you can draw up. Michael Malone's done one hell of a job with this Nuggets team.
Malone, the Western Conference Coach of the Month in April, the same month in which he lost his star, Jamal Murray, said that his guys were soft after game four. Boy, did they show something tonight.
And both teams in the penalty. Both teams have two timeouts remaining. Bridges guarding Jackson. Kennard, he's out of hot hand. Does it again. Kennard with 10 points here in the fourth quarter.
These coaches calling plays for Mikhail Bridges and Luke Kennard shows trust factor and going to the unexpected.
Cameron Payne with the unexpected 29 points tonight. Gets it to Booker. Booker gets inside. And a whistle. Beverly went down. They stopped the play, but I didn't see a call. So Booker picks up his fourth. 106 remaining. Phoenix clinging to this three-point lead.
And do they have the guts to go with a down screen for Luke Kennard again?
Jackson looking for George. And a foul's going to be called on Booker. That's five on Booker. And they're in the penalty, so George will go to the line to shoot two.
But both teams careless. I mean, Devin Booker, play solid defense and trust what you've done all season long. You are allowing, you're doing too much defensively. You're doing too much.
And smart by George to come up and under the arm. Like, that to me could be an offensive foul, too.
And the players have perfected that in terms of drawing contact and getting a call.
And Monty Williams doesn't have his challenge left. He used it earlier in the game.
Well, there's George at the free throw line. He's already missed three free throws. Normally a very good free throw shooter.
I think Monty Williams deciding to not go with a timeout. He wants to put Luke Kennard in the action coming back on the offensive end.
Two clutch free throws there from Paul George. 1 point game. Final minute here in game two. Cameron Payne. Ayton sets the screen.
So they get the matchup that they want with Kennard defending Payne.
Shot clock at six. Payne gets inside. Layup blocked by Zubac. George comes the other way. Here comes Paul George. Gets inside. Layup. He banks it home. And the Clippers take the lead. Timeout Phoenix. This resilient Clipper team bounces back again. For the LA Clippers, they trail by as many as seven here in the fourth.
I'm giving the ball to Devin Booker and getting out of his way.
Booker pulls up, jumper, it's good! Devin Booker drills it, and the Suns back up by one. Timeout Clippers. Some heart-stopping playoff basketball right now. High drama here in Phoenix.
And they took Ayton off the floor to downsize along with the Clippers. There'll be no shot blocking at the rim.
George, jumper, got it! Paul George drills another. Back-to-back huge buckets. Shot clock is turned off, no fouls to give. Suns do have a timeout, decide not to call it. Beverly on Booker. Booker knocked out of bounds. And it's still gonna be Phoenix ball. Phoenix with a chance to get it back and advance it. They throw it in the backcourt to George. And Bridges fouls Paul George, who just hit two big free throws, but he has missed three tonight. Huge free throws here for Paul George. And that's critical, because now, if he hits the second one, Suns only needed two to tie it.
And they've already given up a free throw rebound before. You can't assume. Beverly's pursuit has to be accounted for.
George, who's hit some big buckets down the stretch, missing that free throw. He's got one more. Crowder and Ayton along the free throw lane to make sure they secure it if he misses another. Missed another, and they call timeout. Paul George misses a pair, and the Suns with a chance to win it with 7.8 remaining. 7.8 seconds remaining. Suns to inbound, down by one. Crowder has it. Booker looking to get free. Into the hands of Booker. Booker against Beverly. Finds Crowder. Bridges for three. Won't go. Ball knocked out. And it's still Suns ball with 0.8 of a second remaining, according to the official's first call. But of course, they're going to go check it now. Crowder looking, throws it alley-oop. Oh! Ayton puts it down! He puts it down! It's over!
And they're trying to say goaltending, but that's a live basketball. He can finish it.
Batum lobs it up. Pass George has it. George fires away. No good. It's over. Suns win game two.
Randall gets a Gibson screen. Pull up three. Puts it down. And the Knicks back in front.
What a game, Spiro. And how about the confidence from Julius Randle? Has struggled mightily all game long, but when his team needed him most, how about that pass to Bogdanovich on a string for that triple, and then a beautiful behind the back drop off as Hunter able to knock down that triple back to back. But Julius Randle on cue, able
to answer.
Young turns the corner, hits the floater, and he's got a chance at a three-point play.
He is having his way with the Knicks defense. They're going to have to make an adjustment. He's either making the right read or getting to his spot. Not sure about the foul there, but especially as physical as this thing has been up to this point. But if you're Trae Young, you'll take it.
Trae Young, final nine games of the season, hit the 30-point mark five times, and he has been just incredible down the stretch. 28 for Young, the 22-year-old third-year kid out of Norman, and he's given Atlanta a two-point lead. Rose into the paint, Gibson, outside Burks for three, why not? Alec Burks with maybe the biggest night of his NBA career. Especially when you consider the stakes, Young turns it over.
And I think he thought he was going to get a foul call. They didn't make it, and he tried to make the right play. That was a great decision, too, by Taj Gibson on that kick out. But just a little off on that pass, partner.
Alec Burks has 16 points in the quarter and 25 for the night. Rose, a little shimmy shake, kicks out Burks. Under control, shot, and he hits again. Alec Burks is putting the Knicks on his back.
He has done as good a job as anybody in the NBA. And, you know, the hire of Thibs and World Wide West coming on board. But it's also the personnel moves they made, the decisions, even within the season with Gibson and Rose.
Bogdanović buries a three. And that was cold-blooded. We are tied with under a minute left.
You could not ask for anything more than what we've gotten from these two teams.
A number of players on both teams getting their first taste of the NBA playoffs, and they are coming tonight. Rose the drive and kick. Burks. Rare miss. Fight for it. It's taken by Young. 30 seconds left. Young puts it on the deck. Here he comes. Contact. And boy, that nearly went. Trae Young can give Atlanta the lead.
The Knicks during a regular season and is going to have a chance to hit that mark here potentially tonight.
Trae Young, only player in the league this season who averaged 25 points and better than 9 assists. He's given Atlanta a one-point lead.
And he's also given his team some confidence, knowing that they've got one of those guys that can make plays and free throws down the stretch.
Trae Young, the 22-year-old All-Star, makes it a two-point Atlanta lead, 23 seconds left in regulation. Where do the Knicks go here? It's Randle from three. Way too much. Gibson, offensive rebound. Here comes Burks. Shovel pass underneath, outside to Rose. Into the paint. Shot. Got it. We're tied. 9.8. Both teams in the penalty. It'll be Herter, the inbounder for Atlanta.
And Thibs has gone to its defensive lineup. Neal Akila in the game now, defensively on the point. Let's see how they play this.
Here is Young. Finds his spot. Young on the floater, puts it in. Trae Young with a miraculous shot.
Wow, what an incredible play by Trae Young. Defense broke down, nobody there to help, and Trae delivers.
The Knicks are out of timeouts. They must inbound here as Burks will throw in. 15,000 all standing. Knicks looking for a miracle. Inbound to Randle. Fadeaway shot. And it's over. The Atlanta Hawks come to New York and throw down the gauntlet by taking game one.
28.4 on the game clock. Here's Harden. Hounded by Brown. They get the switch. Brogdon picks him up. And now Horford switches on to Harden. Harden floater for the tie. Got it! 107-107.
15.9 to go. And Joe Mazzulla looks like he's going to let his guys play. He trusts his team. Smart will bring it up. 7 seconds to go. Tatum with the screen. Working against Maxey. Goes quick on the spin. Kicks it out for the win. Smart. And will play overtime. Five more minutes. And James Harden was clutch, Doris. Down by one. Under 2 minutes to go here. Brown into the front court for Boston. Tatum goes to the screen. Back out to Tatum. Eight on the shot clock. Harris switches on to Tatum. Couple of crossovers. Out to Horford for three. A dagger doesn't fall. And here come the 76ers. Maxey hands it off to Harden. Here's Embiid. Goes quickly this time. Back out to Harden for three. Loose ball foul underneath. And that's going to go against Boston.
Is it on Al Horford checking on, trying to check out Joel Embiid?
Yes, it was.
Ball goes up. You seek out the body, but obvious hold and foul. Good call by the official.
Both Boston and Philadelphia with four team fouls here. Harden uses the Embiid screen. Embiid in the lane, draws the hit. And he'll have a chance to put the Sixers up by a point with these two free throws coming up.
This is the benefit of having a big man who shoots free throws with the proficiency of Joel Embiid. All of a sudden, they're able to get to that two-man action. James is able to deliver it to Joel once he feels the contact, easy to put it up and give it a chance.
Embiid shot 86% from the foul line during the regular season. And he ties the game at 112. Up to 33, Harden has 39.
I think they're going to try to get Malcolm Brogdon in here. Not going to make it to the scorer's table on time.
Philadelphia leads by one. 56 seconds to play.
So now do you use the timeout if you're Joe? Nope.
Here's Jaylen Brown. Guarded by Tucker. White on the roll. Sprays it out to Smart. One more to Tatum. Driving against Maxey. No whistle. Tatum got it. Butter. And Boston leads by two. Harden with a crossover on Brown. Got inside. He was looking to hit Maxey. He was right at the rim.
He was at the cup.
Philadelphia.
Marcus Smart draws the look, and now Tatum gets a switch on Embiid.
Embiid bullies his way inside. Out to Harden for the three. Got it! Celtics are going to play. Joe Mazzulla is going to let them go. Down by one. 10 seconds to play. Tatum against Harris. Tatum. Smart. Got it. Did it count?
I don't think he got it off.
Did not get it off in time, it appeared. It appeared to be late. They're going to review it by rule because it went through the basket as the time expired. You can tell by the crowd reaction that he didn't get it off in time.
Tatum on the floor. It was a simple basket from review.
They took way too long, Doris, to get into their action.
There's no question about it, and there's doubt.
That's not even close.
Nope.
The 76ers battle back, and a clutch three ball by James Harden ends up being the decisive stroke.
The basket is unsuccessful.
So the 76ers even the series at two games apiece.
The Heat have really dug in defensively, and now on a 7-0 run. Grant Williams setting the screen for Walker. Hesitation move back to Williams, wide open three. Brown with a spectacular airborne tip. Jaylen Brown makes it a one-point Miami lead. Jaylen Brown quietly with 17 points and 5 rebounds.
Boy, the amount of minutes by some of the players on the floor tonight, plenty of them north of 40 wow. minutes.
Miami has had 6 days off. Jimmy Butler with a blocking foul going to go against Kemba Walker, who's left incredulous by the call. It's over on ESPN News right now, the Clippers and the Nuggets. The winner taking on the Lakers in the Western Conference Finals. Marcus Smart switches back on to Butler. Little ISO on the wing. Butler. Hero for three. And Tatum with the rebound. Boy, that halfway down and out. Adebayo tasked with guarding Tatum. Tough shot. And Miami comes out of the pack with a rebound. Bam Adebayo moving his feet well.
Nice to have your center be able to make that stop.
The reason why he made all defense this year. Butler downhill, off glass, no good. And Boston gets the stop. 39 seconds to go. Dragic on Walker. Good defense, whistle. And Mark Davis calls a foul.
Signals a
Miami
trip.
Had one to give.
Yeah, signaled like a trip, Mark.
Yeah.
So that stumble by Kemba Walker is where they got Goran.
And now neither team with a foul to give as Iguodala comes into the ball game. He'll come in for Dragic.
That's right. As he goes to make this move, their feet get tangled, and that's why the whistle.
That's the fifth on Dragic. Marcus Smart. Pocket pass never made it. And that's going to be a kick ball. Shot clock going to be set at 14. Tatum to inbound. Tough cover for Hero here against Kemba Walker. The step back, he's done it so many times and does it again. Butter, Kemba Walker giving Boston the lead. Jumps to Butler. Guarded by Tatum. Dragic clears it out. Butler downhill on Tatum. Into traffic. Got it! And one! Clutch time, Dade County. Jimmy Butler delivering.
Yet again, the Miami Heat in the paint. And Jimmy Butler again has taken 68% of his shots from right in that area. He is relentless, gets the angle and the step on Tatum, takes the contact and scores it. 48-26, the advantage in the paint, and the Heat bench is like, yes, sir, that's our closer.
Doris, I swear Tatum bounced off him twice on the same drive.
Mm.
The lead is two, and Brad Stevens calls timeout. Eric Jones back in defensively. Tatum out front. Clock at seven, working against Butler, got downhill, couldn't punch it. Bam says, get it out of here. Adebayo, sky high with the block and rejection. That's why he's NBA All-Defensive Team. Bam Adebayo went airborne with Jason Tatum, and Adebayo won. Wow. A meeting at the summit, Doris.
That is a ridiculous defensive play. Now, Jason Tatum is clearly by everybody else, high above the rim. Looks like it's going to be an easy dunk, and Bam says, not in my house.
Bam Adebayo with a great stat line tonight.
misses the free throw, but 17 points, 6 rebounds, 9 assists, and a key block.
No timeouts here for Boston.
Yeah, no timeouts, and it's still just a one-possession game because he missed that free throw.
Make or miss, this is a one-possession game, but you've got to get it to the three-point line in 2.5 if he makes it.
Knocks down the second. The lead is 3. Boston needs a 3. Do they foul or not? We'll see if they do it on the catch. Not. Tatum makes the catch. Got it off in time. Online, but no good. And the Heat win game 1 in overtime.
Ball in the hands of Kawhi Leonard, as it's been all season long for these Raptors. Leonard trying to draw a foul, finds Lowry. 5 to shoot for Lowry. Lowry makes his move. Back up top to Gasol, throws it in the backcourt. And a 24-second violation would have been a backcourt violation either way. It's Golden State ball.
So instead of playing to go ahead after a tip-in, I mean, that's such a huge call from a strategy standpoint. And do they leave Iguodala in, which they decide to do?
Curry has the ball. Minute and a half remaining. Curry gets a look, fires away, ties the game! Steph Curry from downtown! Huge shot. Struggling. The great ones find a way to step up. Leonard looking to answer, steps back. Short. Rebound Danny Green, lost it to Curry. Curry pushing it up. Van Vliet in pursuit. Iguodala back out to Green. Thompson. One fake, one dribble, one shot. Got it! Golden State retakes the lead. Timeout, Toronto. What a turnaround for the Warriors. 9 straight points by the defending champs.
Incredible defensive and shooting response. The semi-transition, the excellent extra pass, and then the shot fake, the side dribble, and the knockdown 3. Warriors up 3.
23 pointers for the Golden State Warriors. And after trailing by 6 here in the fourth, now with a 3-point advantage, just under a minute remaining.
And if you're the Raptors right now, don't fall in love thinking you have to have a 3. Score the basket.
Gasol inside, layup, missed it. Cousins the rebound. Nick Nurse upset, thought there was contact.
Curry's got to get it over.
And just gets it off in time. Green stepped in the backcourt. A backcourt violation.
That's just careless basketball. Clearly steps in the backcourt.
Danny Green, good pressure to help force the turnover on Draymond Green.
They should go 2 for 1.
Lowry fakes. Lowry drives. Layup blocked by Cousins, but a goaltend.
Ed Malloy coming over to check with Jim Capers. And I think they're going to take a look at it.
That should be quick. Clearly goaltended by Cousins.
And it was interesting. They could have substituted Cousins out of the game on that possession. But I think they're overriding, trying to rebound the ball, kept him in the contest.
Clearly off the backboard. Now there's a 5.9 difference between shot clock and game clock. So clearly Toronto does not have to foul. Toronto still has a timeout left, so they need to defend, secure a rebound. Now they're putting some more time back on it, Clark. So it's 6.4.
So you're not gonna foul, but Golden State does have a foul to give. But that backcourt, Mark said, it's unconscionable, that type of mistake in that situation.
Coming down to the final 30 seconds. Van Vliet picking up Curry the entire way. He's got 8 seconds to get it across the timeline.
That to me is just a lot of movement with Curry and Thompson off the basketball trying to get those guys a look.
Iguodala. Off
offensive foul called on DeMarcus Cousins. A moving screen. Oh, incredible.
And it was an easy call.
Cousins, who had played so well, a bad mistake. And Toronto now with a chance to win it with 15.7.
And Sean Livingston coming into the game defensively for DeMarcus Cousins. If I'm the Raptors, I'm going high pick and roll with Kawhi Leonard with no help protection on the rim.
And again, foul to give for Golden State. Want to get it into the hands of Kawhi Leonard. 6 seconds remaining. Leonard back up Van Fleet. Van Fleet kicks it out Lowry. Lowry for the win. Won't go. And there'll be a game six in Oakland.
And it was a great job of double teaming Leonard so he couldn't beat him.
Adetokounmpo sets up shop in front of Vincent.
Milwaukee has to switch every screen. The communication has to be great.
Over the top to Butler. Up and in! Jimmy Butler ties the game with a half second to go.
What a play call.
Milwaukee had a timeout and didn't use it.
Why would you not call a timeout and advance the ball? What is going on here?
What's going on is Jimmy Butler and overtime in game five.
Jimmy Butler runs a little bit of a circle cut. Looks like he's going to go to the corner, circles back, and it's a lob play. And the touch is phenomenal. Jimmy Butler sending us the OT in Milwaukee.
Butler's 40th point of the night resets the clock to 5 in overtime. Can they finish the job?
You gotta send somebody. You can't let Jimmy play one-on-one. And you definitely can't run a drop coverage right here. Send help. Great
solid. Giannis has it in the open floor. Matthews back to Holiday. Cross-court Middleton. Inside Giannis. Vincent on him, up and in. Huge bucket from the Greek Freak. And it's a two-point game. Caleb Martin brings it up for Miami, up by two. Under a minute to play here in overtime. What a game five.
And why isn't Jimmy getting the rock?
Martin massages it.
And Giannis and fouled
by Giannis.
Oh my goodness.
Three free throws for Max Strus.
What? And Giannis, normally a very smart player, didn't have to make this type of play. Max Strus was several steps behind the three-point line, and that is an easy call. That is an emphasis this year. You have to allow shooters to land. That's the Zaza Pachulia Kawhi Leonard.
Yeah. A landing area foul clearly on Giannis. Three free throws now for Max Strus, who shot it just under 88% in the regular season. Just one of one in this series coming in. First one is up and through. Possession game now, and Strus has a chance for one more. Grayson Allen, Pat Connaughton, both in for the Bucks, both three-point shooters. David Highsmith comes in for defensive purposes for Miami. And Strus still waiting for his third free throw. One rattles out. Here comes Middleton with some pace. Connaughton back to him. Contested three, that's well off, but Antetokounmpo is there for the putback.
It's a two-point game. You don't have to foul, but you have to get a stop.
Giannis has 36.
If you're the Milwaukee Bucks, you got to dig deep right here. Jimmy's going to set the screen.
Butler calls out now. They switch. Holiday defends Vincent. In and out. Giannis has it.
Get it to Middleton.
Two-point game. Butler steps in front. Middleton. Allen has it down the lane. He ran out of time. The Bucks don't give up his shot. Oh, and my. The Miami Heat become the sixth in NBA history to win as an eighth seed in the first round.
What a ball game.
From out of bounds, coming inbounds. That's Dragic. Dragic lobs it into Butler. Butler with the Heat down two, waiting. 2 seconds left. Butler for the tie, lays it in. Jimmy buckets. Clutch time, indeed. We have overtime in game one.
Now that was big time. That was, we have nothing, and we throw the ball across the court. And when Butler catches it, he came off that baseline screen, but he didn't have anything. Giannis is on him here right now. He checks the clock, and he makes his move right there. Absolutely great, because he got the shoulder ahead of Giannis right there, and he had the presence to play the glass. Now give Bam a lot of credit, because he got what he wanted defensively. He forced Giannis to go away from the basket and shoot that fade.
Adebayo giving a lot of space, can't squeeze it in. Good contest from Brook Lopez.
Lopez has had an excellent game here today, not only just with the 17 points, but with the 7 rebounds.
104-104, shot clock down to 7. Middleton guarded by Robinson, step back off the mark, rebound nearly squirted out of bounds off Ariza. Here comes Dragic. He has 22 off the bench for Miami. Butler, 2 assists shy of a triple-double. Butler giving space. Can't hit the 3. Good box out from Lopez. And Milwaukee with the basketball in a tie game here in overtime.
Yeah, the pressure is on to hold everybody to one shot. They like this. They're fronting, see? Ariza's done a great job in fronting either Lopez or Giannis in the post area anytime they isolate and they only have one man in that area. Give Ariza a lot of credit. That's hard to do, to front people and then beat them also in case of a lob.
Lopez has been the one Buck to really knock down his free throws in this game. He's 6 for 6. Shot it at 85% in the regular season. Chance to put Milwaukee up here, and he hits the first. You know, you think about this game mentally for Milwaukee, just incredible expectations for the Bucks heading into this postseason after coming up short the last 2 years as the one seed, and specifically trying to exact demons when it comes to this matchup against the Heat team, who was lower seeded and beat them in 5 games in the second round a season ago. As Lopez goes 1 for 2, Miami ball. Adebayo, 50 seconds left in overtime. Out to Robinson, who has 24. Robinson a 3. No. Long rebound. Holiday on the run. Darting ahead. All the way in. Lays it home.
Great hustle.
And Miami will want to go quick enough that they can play straight up defense.
That's right.
With a 2-for-1 opportunity. Butler patiently massaging his way down. Robinson gives it up. Back to Butler, a 3. No. Back tap. Ariza gives it up to Dragic. He got on a 3 to tie it at 107. And now Milwaukee, with the shot clock turned off, can hold for a potential game winner. Crowd rising to its feet. Middleton, 5 seconds left in overtime. Middleton with 2. Middleton, you bet! He got it! With 0.5 to go, Chris Middleton puts the Bucks up 2 here in game one.
That was a big time professional move.
2.5 to go in overtime of game one after Middleton's jumper put the Bucks up by 2 points.
Now you can see they're out of timeouts.
With Giannis in front of them, Miami no timeouts remaining. Here's Butler. Did he get it off? That's it. Game one belongs to the Milwaukee Bucks.
Green will trigger it inbound. Maxey fights free of Trent to get it. Harris to the far side. Nia Barron in the corner. Green to the left of Maxey in the corner. And Embiid on the mid-block. Maxey goes to work. 13 seconds on the shot clock. A differential of three.
Here's the post up. Here's the mid-post up.
Here is Embiid a long way from home with five. He sees a double team. He steps back. Arcs a three up. No. Persisting for the rebound is Harris. He spins inside. He muscles up a shot. No. Rebound corralled by Van Vliet. We're going into overtime in Toronto in game three. How about that end? 30 points, 12 rebounds for the big man tonight. Imposing his will, he's been a punishing factor here for the Sixers.
And especially in the second half. First half, only 5 points, so he really came alive in the second half and gave Philly everything they needed to force his game in OT.
Achiuwa will screen outside. Actually, will jump outside on the switch on Maxey, who probes, eight to shoot. Embiid rumbles into the paint, fallaway jumper. Achiuwa the rebound. Steps back, snap back, triple, glances off the iron. Green claims the rebound, and he got a shot right in the ribs. 53 seconds remaining. Philadelphia with the lead. Doc Rivers windmilling his arms along the sideline as Maxey works the edge. Embiid collects Ananobi on the screen. Achiuwa switches outside on Maxey. Maxey's got to shoot. He's got to shoot. The three does. It's well off the mark.
That wasn't a good possession right there. That's where you can tell they're missing Harden a little bit.
Ananobi crossing, gets to the body of Maxey, goes under, Embiid snuffs it for the whistle and a foul.
Oh wow. That looked like a clean block right there. Let me see it from this angle. They call that foul on Embiid, I don't understand it.
They did.
That is not a foul.
That's his third.
That is not a foul at all.
There was a lot of contact that Maxey put on Ananobi before the gather, that's for sure, but that wasn't any part of the call that they made as Ananobi steps to the line.
If there was a foul, maybe it was on Maxey, but it definitely wasn't on Embiid. He got all ball.
And Philadelphia, of course, had already used the challenge in regulation, contesting the call on Harden, his sixth foul of the game. So here's Ananobi now. He has evened it. He can give him the lead. Rolls 360 degrees and then some. It comes off into the hands of Joel Embiid. We're tied with 19 seconds left. A differential of just under 2 seconds between shot and game clock.
Nick Nurse, they're going to give a foul right here. They're going to give a foul. Well, no, it's not. They're going to play it straight.
It's an option. Jabbed away. 2 seconds. Embiid's going to get caught pivoting.
Are you serious?
Philadelphia had called a timeout.
I'm sorry, that just can't be the possession you get with the game on the line in the playoffs.
2 and 6, 10 seconds remaining in overtime. 0.9 to shoot for the Philadelphia 76ers.
You think Gary Trent Jr. got another bucket in him? Seconds. Obviously going to run some screening outs and try to get something slipping towards the basket and see if you can create some confusion. Oh no, it's still Philly's ball.
Still Philly's ball.
I thought it was Toronto's ball.
No. No. Doc Rivers called the timeout.
I thought it was Toronto's ball.
No, Green will bring it in bounds now with Embiid way outside near the arc. Green may angle something toward the rim. It gives to Embiid. He'll turn. Got off the shot and hit it. Oh my. There's going to count the bucket. But review. A turn, a shot, and a score.
You can't be serious, big fella.
Joel Embiid with a three-pointer has shocked everybody in the building. The catch, the turn, the shot.
Wow. Look at the Philly bench. They're loving it. Wow. I am speechless. Embiid catch, turn, two Raptors on him, it doesn't matter. It's Joel Embiid's world. We're just living in it right now.
Inbounds, it comes to Anunoby, broken up by Green. Anunoby gets off the shot, but not in time. Philadelphia survives in overtime. Joel Embiid, the most improbable fall-away three-pointer to give Philadelphia the win, 104-101.
I'm going to try to get Giannis against Jaylen Brown if I can and let him go, but...
Holiday kicks it, Portis for three. No good. Matthews the rebound. Giannis is going to put up a three. And he'll hit it! Giannis Antetokounmpo! 39 points! He sticks his second three of the game.
Did he point at me on that?
He said
after
that's
I've
for
been
you,
talking
Stan.
About it. That is a big one, and cuts this to three.
He's made his last 2 3-pointers. One possession game here. Tatum rises up. No. Giannis with a rebound. Here come the Bucks.
They want to run. The Celtics are slowing the pace. The Bucks trying to pick up the pace.
Connaughton to Bobby Portis. Oh, he lost the handle. Missed it. And it's into the hands of Brown. Horford with the tip. Bobby Portis. And it slipped right out of his hands on his way in. Giannis has got a stream of blood coming down from his right eye, right above his eye. 8 to shoot. Smart lost the handle. Giannis has it. Bucks want to run. 46 seconds. Bobby Portis gives it up. Holiday for three. Down it goes. We are tied.
Well, you see the difference in style here in the fourth. Milwaukee pushing the ball and getting opportunities in transition. Boston walking everything up and playing the clock.
Milwaukee plus 9 here in the fourth. What a finish here in Boston. Antetokounmpo, Connaughton back on the floor. Coach, it's Boston ball. You saw the timeout situation. Boston with one, Milwaukee with one. Celtics have the ball. They advance it here with 37 seconds remaining.
I would think they go pretty quick here and try. If they can, you want a good shot, but if you can get a 2-for-1, you want to do that. Tatum right to the rim.
Tatum is fouled. Both coaches still have a challenge. Boston back in front. It's Tatum's got 33 now.
Well, the Boston defenders, seen them in this situation before, will be reluctant to come off of shooters. He'll get as much space as he's had at any time in this series.
Boston leads. 7 seconds separating the shot clock and the game clock. Celtics have a foul to give. Giannis falls down and a foul on Grant Williams. Williams guarding out of the Kupo, gives him some space. 8 to shoot. Out of the Kupo goes the hook shot. No, and a foul. And Giannis is going to the line. Now Giannis. Game 5. Coming right down to the finish line. Clutch.
And smooth that one. I mean, just shot it with good motion there. One more. If you're the Celtics here, you have got to block out and get everybody on the glass.
Antetokounmpo is 6 for 9 at the foul line. Missed it. That's it. Portis got it. Portis puts it up. And it goes. And Milwaukee is in front. Boston takes their last time out. An offensive rebound, and Bobby Portis gives the Bucks the lead with 11.4. To this fourth quarter, Milwaukee's gone plus 15 since. They lead by one. Series tied at 2 apiece. Marcus Smart goes to the rack and blocked by Drew Holiday. He throws it off Smart. Milwaukee ball. What a play by Drew Holiday.
That is a great defensive play there. Coming off to help. Connaughton's beat. Drew Holiday, not only the block, but the presence of mind to throw the ball off of Smart. Possession Milwaukee.
Wow. A game and a series that has been defined by great defensive moments. Grayson Allen, the best free throw shooter on the floor. He and Connaughton.
Trying to get it in the hands of Connaughton or Allen. No timeouts, and they just got it in. And Connaughton, who shoots it at 83%, will go to the line to try to make this a three-point Milwaukee lead. Boy, this was close.
Giannis showing great poise here, though, and the Celtics deciding not to put anyone on the ball so he could have clear vision. That's only Connaughton's fourth free throw here. Now, 5.9, and you've got to advance the ball up. If Connaughton makes this, it gives Milwaukee a chance to foul on the dribble coming up.
The Boston area native, Connaughton, calmly knocks in two clutch free throws.
If I'm Milwaukee, I'm not letting this ball get up the floor. I'm taking a foul.
And Horford gives it to Smart. Smart at half court. He's picked by Holiday, and that's going to do it. Milwaukee, a comeback win on the road. They win it 110-107. And Milwaukee leads this best of seven series 3-2.